It is an undisputed truth that education is key in today's society. Whether it be a high school diploma or a general education diploma, a person must be educated to survive and furthermore succeed in life. Children are conditioned all their life to believe that they must mindlessly attend school without question and receive their high school diploma to have a decent chance at life. Unfortunately, in today's world, it is becoming increasingly more difficult to succeed in high school and receive a high school diploma. Many students are faced with difficulties in their home life that make it next to impossible to attend class full time. Many children in poverty-stricken areas must find jobs and support themselves and even their families and have little time to study. Often students decide to drop out of high school and take a general education course and receive their GED. With a GED, a person may attend college, but many universities have a preferred acceptance rate to high school graduates. By law, a child may get their GED and drop out of high school at the age of 16. As the years go by, the rate of high school dropouts has increased so that people can pursue their interests outside of the classroom. Many dropouts decide to get their GED and enter into adult education programs such as nursing that set them up to immediately walk into a profession, while many high school graduates struggle to find jobs. This poses the question of whether or not a high school diploma necessarily ensures success. To help answer this question, we are joined by Ms. Dietz, a teacher for the GED program at Dutchess County's Boces CTI.
Why do I think so many young people choose to do GED? Well, number one, a lot of kids think the GED is really easy till they take the pretest and discover it's not so easy. I feel some kids it's just because they're lazy. Some kids it's just because they can't handle the coursework at their home school. It goes so fast because of regents and teachers trying to get through it so fast. Other kids do it because they have an IEP diploma and they also want a GED on top of it. So there's pros, you know, there's good and there's bad for kids getting their GED.
We all know the challenges of receiving a high school diploma, but what are the requirements for receiving a GED?
A lot of people ask me, how do I get into the GED program? What does it take? You take a pretest, 3 to 4 day pretest, to see if you are at what the state classifies the level for you to be at. You need to be approximately 10th, 11th grade level in reading, math, social studies, science, and grammar, and you also have to be able to write an essay.
So why do so many students decide to drop out? To help answer this, we are joined by two high school dropouts that are currently enrolled in the GED program at Dutchess County Boces.
I dropped out of school because I felt like school wasn't for me. I had screwed up in my earlier years of high school, and I had so much extra work to do. I had to take night classes over at Dutchess, and I had a full schedule, and it was too hard on me, so I decided to get my GED. In the process of taking the pretest, which gets you ready for the class, it lets the teachers know where you need help in, like what subjects, and then you go with the class, and you can be in there from anywhere from 2 years to a month, and you can be ready whenever you're ready. You could take the GED test.
Although it has been proven that high school graduates are more likely to advance their education, that is not to say that GED recipients can't follow their dreams.
You can go to college with a GED. You can go out and work in the workforce. So, you know, a lot of people look down on GEDs, but I think GEDs for many kids is a very wise alternative.
I fooled around and I got left back twice and I decided that, you know, I didn't want to be in high school forever, being that I'm 19, so I just decided why not just get a GED.
Often, students do not take school as serious as they should and fall behind in their schoolwork. Sometimes when a student gets their GED, they can also attend a trade program like the ones provided by Boces.
Well, I've always wanted to be an actress and I'm not really sure if they require GED. I doubt it. But since I'm doing Media Technology Arts, my afternoon trade definitely helps that because we do script writing and we also do video recording and some acting. So that definitely helps as well as basically being an actress, which I've always wanted to be, so it prepares me, in other words.
To show the benefits of graduating from high school, we are joined by a graduate of Stissing Mountain Junior Senior High School, Shane Van Curen. Shane shares with us what he enjoyed about high school.
Basically, more towards the end, when it was getting closer to getting out, and honestly, when I was involved with more of the activities, when I started doing more sports, just socially created a better network of people, got to know more people, got to know my teachers better.
And the things he found difficult.
Mainly the staying on schedule part, which is probably still my biggest challenge in anything else I do. But I had a lot of last minute projects and homework assignments and yeah, all that stuff. But other than that, not too much.
Often people are unsure of what they want to do for a career. Many people need the high school experience to realize what they truly want to do.
Most of the way through high school, I thought I wanted to do pyrotechnics, which would have involved a lot of chemistry probably. But towards the end, senior year, I got more involved in psychology, took a psych class, and since then I've been taking any psych classes that I could, and that's how I ended up where I am now, working with autistic adults. So basically I figured it out senior year. Until then I was kind of back and forth on my ideas. I started at DCC, I did 2 years there with a liberal arts degree. I went to Northeastern University in Boston for a semester, spent too much money there, came back and finished at Pace University, where I'm pretty much done. Technically, still owe them a couple classes to get my degree. Well, the job I have now actually requires a 4-year degree. It doesn't require it in my field, but it does require that you have one. So without it, I couldn't actually do what I'm doing. It's helped me learn a lot of things to help me be more well-rounded too, just get a better idea of where I want to go, which kind of changes slightly in direction every now and then.
A group of 4 high school seniors were asked why they think a high school diploma is important. This is what they said.
I feel a high school diploma is important because although the education itself isn't, you know, in my opinion, a valid interpretation of how knowledgeable you are in the real world, I feel like in the job field, they, you know, require you to have it. And nowadays, you even need college. So, I mean, to not have your high school diploma, you're kind of signing yourself a death wish, and you're going to be having to work harder the rest of your life.
I think a high school diploma is important because if you want to get a real job in life, then you have to go through high school all the way instead of just dropping out and getting a GED, because GEDs aren't going to give you the right job and it's not going to give you the job you want. So in order for you to succeed in life, you have to get your high school diploma.
Well, a high school diploma is important because you can't really get anywhere today without even a high school or even a college diploma. You can't really advance yourself.
Because with the way the society is today, people need extra education so that they have proof that they're good at something so that they can get into something when they get older. Because, like, if I don't have a diploma, how am I going to get into something? You know, like, how do I have proof that I'm good at it, you know? Like, I don't know. Like, say I wanted to be into, I don't know, like, filming or whatever. How do I have proof that I'm good at it? Because I did it in school. I have a diploma to prove that I'm good. You know, without that, how am I going to prove it? I don't know. Some people it works, but like other people, it's just smart to get a diploma just in case. It's like a net that'll catch you.
All 4 students shared similar views about receiving their high school diploma. The same 4 students were asked what they plan to do with their high school diplomas when they graduate in June 2011.
After I receive my high school diploma, I'm hoping to, you know, go to college and, you know, set myself up to get a good job, you know, a career. So, you know, I won't have to work part-time, like, you know, kind of child jobs anymore. You get into the real world, you work a real job, you know, salaried. That would be what I would want to do.
I want to be a massage therapist. In order for me to be that, I have to have my high school diploma because I have to go into college and get my high school and college diploma.
Well, a high school diploma is important to me because that's, you got to get that, and then you can move on to the college, And what I want to do is I want to get a 2-year associate's degree at Dutchess and then just start going in the workforce with film editing and graphic design.
Well, what I want to do is I want to go to Dutchess Community College and I want to get a 2-year associate's degree. And I'm into filming and graphics and photography, so that's what I want to do. And I've been starting that stuff since like 9th grade, and I've been working on that, and now I'm a senior, so I've been working on it for like 4 years. And yeah, so I have proof that I'm good at it because I got pictures, I got film, I have stuff to put in my resume, and I'll have a degree.
Statistics show that 65% of students who go to college with a high school diploma leave with their degree, whereas only 15% of GED recipients who go to college leave with a degree. While statistics show that a high school diploma greatly increases your chances at furthered education and a rewarding career path, history has shown that a high school diploma has nothing to do with success. Many people have found success in life without their high school diploma. Some of these success stories include Quentin Tarantino, Johnny Depp, Chris Rock, Jim Carrey, John Travolta, Tom Petty, Nicolas Cage, and the guy who created Wendy's. This proves that having a high school diploma does not ensure success, because the Baconator was created by a man without a high school diploma, and it is the greatest cheeseburger in the world.